Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Fred Varco, a former secretary of the club. Before we start, can I make sure everybody has turned off their Keitai telephones? Sitting at my far right is Mr. Takashi Yamaguchi, who is one of four lawyers accompanying our guest here today, and he also acts as interpreter. We're very pleased to welcome, if I can say it, Rokudenashiko, or Megumi Igarashi, who has become famous in the last week or two, more famous probably, for her portrayals of vagina art, of which I know very little, and I'm sure she will explain very soon. In my morning research for this press conference, I Googled the word vagina in Japan and came up with many, many uncensored photos of vaginas, which I don't bring with me today. I also found out that you can actually rent vaginas in places such as, well, just a few stops up the Yamanote line from here. And in fact, if you pay extra, you can take photographs of them as well. This case is obviously about obscenity laws, which personally I feel are fairly ridiculous in Japan. And I'm very happy today that we have Yamaguchi-san, the lawyer, and Rokudenashiko, speaking for us today. So please welcome our guest.
Can she start?
Yeah,
please. Hajimete moraemasu ka?
Hai.
Ja, genko yonde. Ah, dozo, hai.
To. To, minasama, konnichiwa. Honjitsu koko ni kouして 海外の文化を背景に持つ皆様の前でお話しできることを大変光栄に思います。交流中の6日間は大変に辛く、女子留置場の厳しい現状を目の当たりにいたしましたが、弁護士の先生方、全国、そして世界中の支援者の皆様のおかげで、裁判所の判断により無事こうして釈放され、今は大きな喜びと感謝の気持ちを感じています。
Sorry, before we translate that, I must point out that the police are still investigating this matter, and it may happen that Yamaguchi-san or one of the other three lawyers here will jump in to prevent our guest from incriminating herself in any way. So please go ahead.
Okay. Hello, everybody. I am very honored to be given this opportunity to speak in front of an audience that comes from various foreign cultural backgrounds. The 6 days in the lockup was very hard days for me, and I was able to realize the harsh realities of the ladies' jail in Tokyo. But thanks to my lawyers and all the supporters all over Japan and from the world, by the judgment of the court, I was released, and I am very happy to be able to be here today.
今回の逮捕は大変急なものでした。休日の朝9時に約10名ほどの捜査員が自宅に入り、作品の説明を求めた後に乱暴に作品類を押収し、手錠をかけられました。一国家権力が私のようなフリーランスで週3日のアルバイトで頑張って生きているような人間をあっさりと逮捕した現実は今でも非常に憤りを感じます。
My arrest came without a warning. On a holiday at 9 a.m., about 10 policemen came into my house and asked me to explain about my artwork.And after that, they confiscated my artwork, handcuffed me, and took me away. I am very angry about the very fact that the law enforcement, who has decided to bully on a person like me, who is a freelance artist, and working 3-day part-time job shifts to make a living and to make an arrest without warning.
今回の罪状は、わいせつ電磁的記録媒体頒布罪ということですが、私はそもそも警察がクラウドファウンディングというシステムを明確に把握していたのかが疑問でなりません。私は自身の助成金の CAD データをクラウドファンディングで募金支援をしてくださった方々に対してお礼の形として送付いたしました。 CAD データは特殊なソフトを介さなければ視覚化することができず、それ自体は数字の羅列のようなものです。頒布した理由はデータをもとに一人一人マンコを使った面白い作品を作ってみてほしいという考えからでした。
I was charged with the crime of distributing obscene data, but I am very suspicious whether the prosecutor and the police had understood about the crowdfunding system. I have given the CAD data of my vagina to the people who has made a contribution through the crowdfunding. CAD data cannot be visualized unless you use a special software, and data itself is merely a number, group number of zeros and ones. I distributed data because I wanted the people who received them to make their artwork based on that data.
そもそも私は自身の肉体から離れた同型物を私の体の一部とはみなしておらず、デコマンなどの石膏、シリコン作品もマンボートも私の肉体を元にした造形ではあっても肉体性を有するものとは考えておりません。ここを触ると気持ちがいいんだろうと石膏作品を触ってみせる男性もよくいましたが、石膏を触って気持ちが良くなればそんなに楽なことはありません。そういった浅はかな男性の存在もまた私のマンコアートの原動力となっていきました。
I do not consider any of my creations that has been separated from my body as an extension or a part of my body. So Decoman or Manboat, they may have originated from my body. The images of the Decoman and the Manboat may have originated from my body, but I do not consider them to be an extension or a part of my body. I have seen men who had looked at my artworks in plaster and touched them and says, if you touch here, don't you feel good? But if a man could make a woman feel good by touching a plaster molded vagina, the sex would be so easy. The such existence of these foolish males have also been an empowerment of making such artworks.
日本のメディアではマンコと発言したり表記することが不可能な状況です。テレビではノイズによりマンコという言葉を書き消され、マンコと発言した女性有名人たちが番組を降ろされるという事件も実際に起こっています。ちなみにチンコという発話は特に問題とならないのも大きな疑問です。紙媒体でもマンコは伏せ字を使って表記されることがほとんどです。そういった女性器、わいせつ、隠して当たり前という常識とその弊害について改めて疑問を提示するために私は活動を続けてまいりました。
In Japanese media, it is impossible to say or express the word manco. In television, if you express the word, it will be scraped out by a P soundAnd I have heard female celebrities who have used the word manco and on television removed from the broadcast from later on. And to the contrary, the use of the word chinko, which refers to the male genitals, has not been a made problem. I think this is unfair. Even in paper media, When you try to express the word manco, it is usually scribbled out, or at least a part of it is made in black. Such common sense with the brackets that female genitals are obscene and should be hidden, I have a very doubt about it. And to show that I have doubt about it, I have continued, that is one of the reasons that I have continued on with my artwork.
女性器は女にとっては生理、セックス、妊娠、出産と自分の肉体の一部としてあまりにも身近なものです。それがわいせつという言葉によって女性の持ち物でもあるにもかかわらず、女性器がどこか遠い存在になっている。これはおかしいのではないか。そういった思いが私の根底にはあります。女性器はありのままでいいじゃないか。という考えが私にデコマンやその他の作品類を作らせているのです。
Vagina, for a woman, when it comes to like periods, sex, pregnancy, and making birth, is a very familiar part of a body. But however, the concept of obscenity alienates the vagina, although even though it is something that belongs to a woman, I have very doubts about these notions. And it is what has inspired me to continue on with various artworks such as Dekoman.
おかげさまで女性の間でデコマンは大人気で作りたいという女性からの声も多いです。女性は自分の性器と向き合う機会が非常に少なく、体の一部なのに歪んだイメージを持っている人も多いです。私もそうでしたが、デコマンは自分のありのままを愛するきっかけにもなっています。
Fortunately, the Dekoman is very popular among the women, and I hear many requests that they want Dekoman made from their own genitals. Women have very little opportunity to see their genitals outright, and many of them have an obscure image, even though it is a genuine part of their body. I think this happens because of the obscene image that has been placed on the female genitals. I was no exception, and creating Dekoman has given me an opportunity to love myself as a whole.
海外の皆様、日本では昔からの性器を奉る信仰がある一方で、こうした日本独特の猥褻感が存在します。今回の私の逮捕は、そうした日本の性的なイメージに関する歪みが私個人の逮捕という形で現れたものではないかと考えます。私は釈放はされましたが、まだ取り調べ中の身ですし、再逮捕という可能性も拭いきれません。どうか女性器のイメージについて問い直したい。ヒゲでも来賛でもなく、女性器のイメージをもっと重要なものにしたいという私の活動の意図を一人でも多くの皆様に知っていただきたく思います。
My dear guests from abroad, Japan traditionally has had the religion had worshipped the genitals, but on the contrary, we also have this sense of obscenity. The very reason that I was arrested.I think is an obscurity of these such Japanese image for that the Japanese had obscure images that the Japan had towards the genitals of the woman. I was released, but the police are still trying to interrogate me, and there is a chance that I may be arrested again. Please, I want you all to understand that my idea.That I want to re-question the images of the vagina, and not to praise or degenerate them, but just a moderate image of the vagina is something that I want you all to understand.
また逮捕後に私の釈放を求めるデジタル署名活動が起こり、1週間もしないうちに約2万人の方々の賛同を得たと伺いました。心より 感謝申し上げます。これは今回の逮捕は多くの一般市民の皆様方もおかしいと感じてくださっているのだと思い、改めて本事件の正当性を問うていきたいと思います。
I also heard that right after my arrest, an online petition was started asking for my release, and about 20,000 people had signed the petitions in less than a week. I want to use this place to thank everybody who has signed the petitions. I think this shows that even the general public has doubts about the legitimacy of my arrest. I want to continue challenging the legitimacy of my arrest and the charges that has been placed against me.
今後も逮捕・拘留の経験にめげず、信念の赴くままに創作活動を続けていきたいと考えております。ご支援のほどどうかよろしくお願いいたします。
Even though that I was arrested, I will continue on with my artwork, true to my beliefs. Thank you all for your future support.
Thank you very much for that informative speech.Before we go to questions and answers, I'd like to ask Yamaguchi-san just to explain some of the legal aspects of this, if he could.
Legal aspects?
Yeah.
Okay. First of all, I could go on and on, but you don't want me to do that.
Briefly,
right? First of all, Japan has an Article 175 in the Criminal Code, which punishes distribution, sales,or publicly presenting obscene material or data. Anybody violating it could be punished by up to 2 years in prison or not more than 2.5 million yen in fine. Now, this is just the provision in the criminal code, which was applied to the case of Miss Igarashi. And what is obscene?Obscenity has been described in a case called Madam Chatley's Lover case. And there's three elements in which our courts have defined the concept obscene. The first element is that obscenity is something that wantonly stimulates or arouses sexual desire. Okay, that's the one. That's criteria number one. And the criteria number two,it offends the normal sense of sexual modesty of ordinary persons. And the third criteria, and is contrary to the proprieties of sexual morality. Now, all these three criteria have to be met to determine if an artwork or whatever is obscene.Obscenity is not limited. It could be just sounds, it could be just text, it could be art, and it could be literature. It's not limited. And different, I know that many of you are from the United States, and I know the United States has similar obscenity rules, but whereas in the United States, obscenity is considered an issue of fact, in Japan, it is considered an interpretation of law. So it's not an issue of fact. So the various, so the judges have a very broad, discretion about determining what is obscene. What is the guideline for obscenity is called the prevailing social ideas in respect to sex. But it's very vague and it changes from time to time. Anything else that I need to add?
Oh, no, that's fine. Thanks. Okay. That's good. Okay, we'll go to questions and answers now. Anyone who has a question, please raise their hand.Come up to the microphone and state your name and your affiliation, if you could, please. Hi.
Hi, I'm Nancy Snow. I'm from the United States, and I'm really fascinated with this issue on several levels. One, the double standard, apparently, which you all addressed. Two, the issue and how it... projects a certain image of Japan in the world. I'm actually doing a book on nation brand Japan. And this story has gone international. And part of it's because it's kind of got a weird, wacky angle to it. But also, it raises some very serious questions about what happens here internally, because it's well known for those of us who study Japan that pornography is very big here. And so, you know, and sexualized images of women especially are very prominent. So is I really want to salute you as an artist, frankly, for raising some critical questions and critical issues related to law and image and a lot of other things happening here. So could you just address those? Thank you.
If you next, people who make questions, if you could do it a couple sentences time and pause, it'll be easier for me to translate. So sorry. まず、あなたの発表を聞いてとても感銘を受けましたって言ってます。で、結局今回の問題っていうのは、どういう点を打ち出しているかというと、一つ目としては、男性と女性について明らかに性器とか性表現について二重の問題があるということと、あともう一つは今回の事件っていうのは国際的に注目を集めていて、で結局日本が世界からどう見られているかということにですね、影響を与えられているということなんです。ご存知の通り、日本では、いわゆる性表現産業、プロノグラフィーの産業というのは非常に大きな産業になっておりまして、女性の体のですね、性の、商品化というのはものすごくたくさんあるんですけども、その中でやっぱりあなたがですね、今回このような作品を撮って、女性の性と性の問題、性器とかね、その捉え方の問題について、問題提起をしたということについて非常にですね、深い敬意を表したいというふうに思っております。 But it's not a question, right? It was a comment, right?
Okay. I think she wanted you to address the issue. And if I could expand on that, maybe you were implying there's a whole lot of hypocrisy here.
Indeed.
Could you address the issue of hypocrisy in Japan? I mean, how I said you can rent vaginas from women up the road here, but you can't actually make a model of your vagina. Is this one of the issues that we're addressing here?
例えばね、ちょっと彼女の質問を彼の方で敷衍してね、お尋ねするんだけど、例えば明らかな矛盾というか、その的なものがある。例えば実際に女性の性というもの、つまり女性のバギナ、マンコというものを買うことができるにもかかわらず、その型を取ってね、データとしてスキャンしてデータとして配ったらいかんというのは、これは明らかな矛盾のように思えるんだけども、その点についてRokudenashikoさんはどう思われますかという質問です。
はい、ですね、私もすごく日本が矛盾しているなと思いまして、例えば電車の中吊り広告とかでは、ものすごく子どもやいろんな人が見る場ですごくわいせつな文章で煽ったりとかしている広告が堂々と出てたりして、もうそれこそそういうものを見たくもないのに見させられる方が不愉快というか。で、一方でこういう活動でなんていうんですかね、マンコというものそのものに悪いイメージを与えて、それがいけないものみたいにして、なんだろうな、それその見方がとても男性目線的で、女性の主体性が全くないんです。それがおかしいと思ってずっと活動してきております。
I think there is hypocrisy too. For example, any of you has ridden the trains or the subways in Tokyo, you could see these ads that are hanging from the ceilings from these trains, and you see a lot of advertisements which is of the sexual nature, and which is something that you cannot avoid because it's not zoned or anything. You're compelled to see it, and I consider that to be very unpleasant. To the contrary, I was arrested because because I don't know, some people have placed the bad image with the word manco, and saying that it is something wrong or something bad that should not be given attention. And I think all these such notions, social notions, are based on the men's viewpoint, and there is a lack of sovereignty or the independency by the woman's viewpoint, and I think that is very wrong. Okay.
Next question over here.
Andy Staples, Economist Corporate Network, and delighted to see you here today. I was also delighted to sign the petition last week to get you out, and thank you for your efforts. 皆さん、あなたと会うことができてとても光栄に思えております。実は私はあなたの釈放を求めるデジタル署名に協力させていただきました。
Thank you very much.
So I have two short questions. First, why do you think this happened now? Did you have any sort of forewarning that this might come across?And the second question, and sorry to be a bit off topic, but what do you think the implications of this experience are for Abenomics, for womenomics, for the role of women in society? Thank you.
Are you saying that, that this arrest has impact? Are you saying that it had, what impact this case has on Abenomics, or whether Abenomics or other implementations against women have any impact, caused this case? Which context? Sorry.
In the context of this great push by Prime Minister Abe to get more women into the
workforce, what are the implications of that? Okay, okay, I understand. Thank you. まあ、ちょっとそれでですね、2つ質問があります。1つ目はなぜ今この時期に今回あなたが摘発されたんでしょうかと。何か事前に警告のようなものがあったんでしょうかということが1つ目の質問ね。で、2つ目の質問は、アベノミクスもあるし、あと安倍首相が女性のですね、まあ、社会参加ということを盛んに推してるんだけども、その流れの中に対して、今回の摘発というのはどのような影響を与えるというふうにお考えでしょうかと、2つの質問があります。
はい、まず、何の警告もなされず、突然逮捕されました。
First, as to your first question, there was no warning. They just came and arrested me.
去年から週刊誌、大手出版社の週刊誌では、しょっちゅう女性記特集という変な特集を組まれてまして、まあ、その中でも私の活動を取り上げてくれた雑誌もあったんですけれども、私の作品以上にその週刊誌の方でいろんな、まあ、マンコのテーマにしたものをずっとやっていて、その中で 3D スキャンをしたっていう特集もあったんですけれども、なぜか私が逮捕されてしまいました。
Ever since last year, the major magazines in Japan making a lot of coverage about the issue of vagina and vagina art, and of it included 3D images of the actual vaginas were included in it. And some of these magazines have come to interview me and introduce my works. But with among all these artworks, I do not know why the police had just chosen me as their target.And she'll go on to the second question.
質問。はい。二つ目の質問は、要するに、まあ、アベノミクスとか、あとそれからあと女性の社会進出ということは安倍政権は盛んに表に出してるけども、そのこととね、今回の事件、摘発を行われたということの、はどういうふうにお考えになるかという質問。
安倍政権になってから、とても右傾化しているように感じまして、もっと80年代の日本の女性はもう少し元気、もっと元気だったと思うんですけれども、どんどんなんか保守的になっているように感じます。今回の件もそういうのは少なからず影響されたんじゃないのかなと思ってます。
Ever since Prime Minister Abe came to power, I think Japan is going in direction of the right, is trying to make a right turn. And I think that the women in the 80sspoke out more and were more active compared to that right now. And I think this issue of, but now the women right now are becoming a lot more conservative, and this may have had some effect on this case.
Okay, next question. Okay.
フランス店の井川と申します。フランスのテレビでは日本の性カルチャーというのが、まあ、大変多種多様で、それを紹介する番組というのを私はフランスにいるときいくつか見たことがあります。ただ一つどの番組にも共通して、奇妙な事態として、なんで男性器あるいは女性器をモザイクで隠すのか かということがジョークとして扱われました。ここで一旦切った方がよろしいんですかね。
そうですね。Okay, you want me to translate the question so for the audience? His question was that, first of all, this gentleman comes from a television in France, and programs that make a lot of coverage about the sexual culture in Japan is very popular in France. But in France, it is always a butt of a joke. Why do all these Japanese sexual programs have these scribbles or these mosaics placed on the genitals, regardless whether it's female or male?
それで私は43年前からゲームムーブメントに携わっていた東郷健という人の本を英語と日本語で出したことがあります。そして東郷さんというのは何回もわいせつ関連の放棄で逮捕されまして、それを最高裁まで争ったりとか、あるいは選挙に出て訴えたり、政見放送でそれを反対することを訴えたりしました。それで質問が、端的に申し上げますと、東郷さんのように例えば選挙に出て訴えるとかですね、あるいは最高裁まで徹底して争うとか、あるいは芝居、自分の後でこの逮捕の不当性を訴えるということは、するおつもりはあるのかということでございます。
前提として今回のまだ裁判になってないので、最高裁までいけるかどうかわからないという前提があります。
書類送検の可能性もあるということ。
書類送検というか、まあ、不起訴になってしまえば最高裁行くまでもない、うん、はい、ちょっと前提としてそれは、
はい、わかりました。
And what he has also added is that there was a person called Ken Togo who was a gay rights activist who has been acting in this for like 43 years, and he has been charged with various obscenity charges, and you know, he has fought for his rights in the Supreme Court, and he also, you know, ran for a public office in elections and tried to, you know, spread to the word public about what his beliefs are. My question would be very straightforward. First of all, do you have any plans for running an election? And number two, do you have any plans for fighting all the way to the Supreme Court? Then I interjected a little bit, telling that she has not been formally charged or indicted yet, so we're not really sure even if this case would go to court. So I just briefly commented on that. And so...
まず一つ目としては、はい、いや選挙に出る気があるか、最高裁まで戦う気があるかということなんですよ。すごいまとめてしまうとね。
起訴されたら最高裁までは頑張り、信念を貫きたいです。
If I should ever be indicted in this case, I would fight all the way to the Supreme Court.
それから選挙に出る気は？
マンコとですか？
Well, she said something about Manco Party. But I want to consult my lawyer before if I may start making any political moves. Is that okay?
Okay, next question. Hi, over here.
フリーランスの久保でございます。この前ありがとうございました。英語で質問いたします。I heard a rumor that you've had plastic surgery on your vagina. Can you verify this? And why would you want to change your vagina through plastic surgery? Could you give us a reason?
すいません。ちょっとこれは噂で聞いたんですけど、あなたは自分の女性器に整形手術を施したという噂を聞きました。で、なぜご自分の性器に整形手術を施したいというふうに思われたのか、差し支えなければお答えください。
先ほどの方の質問の中でもあったように、日本では性器にモザイクがかけられて、どういうものかが分かりづらい、分かんないのですが、と私はだからそのずっとモザイクをかけられているので、他の人がどういう形かも分からなかったんですね。それでネットで検索すれば出てくるっていう知識がちょっとなかったんで、自分の形がなんか人より変なんじゃないかという悩みをちょっと抱えてたんですけれども、それで整形手術をしたんですけれども、した後で、別にその私の形は特に異常じゃなかったっていうことに気づきました。
As you know, you know, in Japan, the mosaic or scribbles is placed on the genitals. So I had no images of what other women's genitals look like. And so I didn't really know. And I was, you know, and when I looked at mine, I became very anxious that maybe my genitals were very deformed or obscure, and I didn't know. But I didn't think about really going on the internet and searching for it, searching for these images on the internet. So I became very anxious that my vagina may have been deformed, so that is why I decided to get a plastic surgery.
Next question.
フリーランスの江川です。よろしくお願いします。ちょっと事実の確認をしたいのですけれども、先ほどそのクラウドファンディングについて警察や検察がどうも誤解しているんじゃないかということですが、これはその売ったのではないのに売ったというふうにされたというそういう意味なのでしょうか。
ちょっとここでちょっとよろしいですか。はい。My first question is that I want to confirm the facts first. You had mentioned before previously that the police and the prosecutor may seem to have misunderstood about the concept of crowdfunding. Are you mentioning that they had made a misunderstood in the context that they had thought that you were selling your data of the data of your vagina?
というふうに思ったという意味なんでしょうか。
はい、そう、逮捕された時の罪状を読んだところ、ちょっとこの人たちはクラウドファンディングのことを理解していないなと思って、私の方から説明したんですけど、何回も説明してもなんか分かってなくてですね、供述書を2回目ぐらいでやっと理解してたみたいですね。
When I was arrested, they had read the charges against me. And when I heard what they had read against me, I thought that they had misunderstood about what the crowdfunding was. So I had to explain them thoroughly. And they still didn't seem to understand. I think it was after about like two statements, police statements were made, they seemed to have finally understood what the concept of crowdfunding was.
でその送った人が、まあ、30人ぐらいというふうに報道されてましたけれども、送った人の人数と送った人の条件というか、例えばいくら以上寄付してくれた人に送るとか、あるいは希望した人に送るとか、何かこうどういう人に送ったのかということについて、もう少し詳しく教えてか、正確に教えてください。
And I have,
で何人送ったのかも。
And I have also read on the news coverages that you have sent the data to variously to about 30 people or more.Can you specify about what were your criteria about when deciding who to give the data to and everything?
はい、ですね、3000円以上募金をしてくださった方にのへのお礼として、3D マンコデータのですね、ダウンロードができる URL 期間限定の7日間限定の URL をキャンプファイヤーというクラウドファンディングのメーラーから3000円以上の方に一斉送信することができるんですけれども、それで送りました。
I sent about 30 people who have made contributions of more than 3,000 yen as a show of gratitude, and among them I sent them a URL that specified in which you could click and download the 3D data of my manko, and the URL itself was expired within a week.
ですのでデータそのものを送ったというものでもなく、またキャンプファイヤー その私 のプロジェクトに賛同してくれた方がお金を入れてくださったので、私 のこの主張通り のマンコは猥褻ではないと思っている考えに賛同してくれている方に私は送ったつもりですし、向こうもそのように思っていると理解しております。
So I did not send the data itself. I just sent the URL. And those people who have URL are people who have agreed with my ideas about my artwork. And so I only sent these data to the supporter, my supporters.
Okay. Can you go to the mic again if you have follow-up?
クラウドファンディングをすると募金をするときに3000以上募金してくださったらこういうものを差し上げますよっていうようなことも事前に報告していたわけです。
そのクラウドキャンプファイヤーのプロジェクトページがありまして、そこに全部500円以上の人はこれリターンが全部書いてあります。
で、そのダウンロードはしてもしなくてもいいわけですね。その個人に任されると。
はい。7日間の間にその方が開かなかったら見れません。
わかりました。ありがとうございます。
And so Ms. Egawa's question was that what was the like if you make was it written beforehand on the web page that if you make a contribution of about more than 30,000 yen that you will be entitled to the 3D data of my vagina? And her answer to that was yes. I mentioned explicitly on my website that the website, the campfire, it's the website name is called Campfire, but on the website that if you make this amount of contributions, you would get something like this. It was also made, it was made very clear on the website itself.
Okay. Gentlemen at the back.
Hi, Cheng from Reuters. I'm still a bit fuzzy about your current status. Are you on bail? Have the police dropped charges? What is your current status? That's the first thing.
第一の質問としては、ちょっとすみません。私、ロイターの記者なんですけども、あなたの今の状況というのは、今法的な状況というのは、一体どういう状況なんですか。あなた保釈されたりとかそういう状況なんでしょうか。You want me to answer that question? I think it's a legal question.
Okay, hold on. I need to go back to switch my camera. That's the first question. The second thing, just before you were released, because obviously you have been released. Did the police pressure you in any way? Did they tell you before you left, don't rock the boat? If you rock the boat, we will arrest you again. Did you receive any sort of pressure from the police? What was their attitude like?
You mean before she was released?
Yes, before she was released. Did the police just pressure her, or what was the attitude of the police?
一つ目の質問、それからもう一個二つ目の質問は、あなた、まあ今釈放されたら釈放される前にね、なんか騒ぎを起こしたらお前もう一度ぶち込むぞとか、また逮捕するぞとか、なんかそういうふうに脅されたりしたということはあるんでしょうかという質問ですね。
Yep, and the third one would be, how do you see this whole thing play out? What's the final end game that you want to see? How do you see this whole case develop? Because it does come across as like a slightly like a Obokata Kenkyuin case where she was whacked down basically. Yeah. So is this like how do you see this whole case develop, and what do you want to see happen with this whole incident?
So excuse me, as to your third question, are you saying that? Are you asking, sir? I don't know what you were trying to ask.
I'm asking, what is the end game that she wants to see? What is the ideal scenario? What does she want to see happen?
The ideal scenario, yes, and
what she wants, if she has her wish, what does she want to see happen for this whole incident?
Thanks. どういうふうにね、あなた自身としてはこの事件はどのように終わってほしいか、あるいはこの事件によってどのような変わってほしいかということについての意見を求めるという3つの質問があるんですよ。I'm going to answer the first question, okay? It's a legal question. First of all, she's not on bail, okay? The judge at the Tokyo District Court issued a detention order, and the detention order itself is appealable, okay? So a detention order is issued by a single judge, but we have a process called the junkokoku, in which a literal translation it would be like a quasi appeal, and it's a process that it doesn't go to a higher court, but it would be reviewed by a tribunal consisting of three judges, and we filed for a junkokoku, a quasi appeal against the detention order. The court agreed with us and said and terminated the original detention order, so she was released. So it's not an issue of bail or anything. For your information, she was not indicted, okay? In Japan, before you're, unless you are formally indicted, you do not have a right to be released on bail. Is that okay for my for your first question? Is that okay?
The 第二の質問の方どうぞお願いします。
She said she forgot what her second question was.
Did the police pressure you?
She says she doesn't. She didn't receive any special pressure when she was released.
The police didn't say anything to her, like, don't draw pictures of your vagina or something?
She says that the police mentioned these things, that don't do kind of these things again during the interrogations while she was still detained.
この3つ目の質問はこの事件がどのように終わってほしいか、この事件を通じて世の中どう変わってほしいかということです。はい、ですね、やっぱり私は誰にも誰阻止されずに自分のマンコアートをまた続けていきたいので、そのようにできるように復帰をされることを願っております。
I want the charges against me dropped so I can continue with my monk art without any interference.
そして日本が。まあ、なんかあとはなんか自分どういう影響があるかと思う。はい、あ、ただこの事件をきっかけにこのように、海外の方や、日本国内でも、ツイッターなどでかなり議論になったことが、今までずっとマンコは無視されてきたので、とても有意義な、
I think it's very fruitful that the issue of Manko has received such public attention from domestically, like especially on Twitter and all over and worldwide, that this issue has been given light.
You asked already first.
Hi, I'm Kirk Spitzer with USA Today. Just some basic details. Can you tell me when, I'm unclear, when were the emails sent and when was the money collected?
まず基本的な事実関係についてお尋ねしたいんですけども、あなたが電子メール、今回で起訴された案件について、電子メールを送ったのはいつで、またそのお金というのはいつ入金されたのかということについてお答え願いますか。
3月の時点の話は、クラウドファウンドで募金をしてくれた人が、7日間限定のURLを開かなった人もいて、後ほど、あれをもらってないみたいな人が、直接ホームページお問い合わせから来たんですね。で、私も誰だったか、そのアカウント名とかだったりするので、ちゃんと把握してないんですけれども、クラウドファウンドに出資した一人なんだけど、もらってないっていう方には送るようにしたんですね。なので、多分、これは、3月の話は、後ほどの話なんですね。で、実際、3D マンコボートプロジェクトは、9月に、
She said that she originally sent the data in somewhere in September, October last year because it was when the project was over. But according to the official charges, she's being charged with the sending that took place this March. And that because what happened was that some people who received these emails, okay, as I've told you before, the URLs had a deadline. It had to be opened within a week. They didn't open it, expired, so they just have to be sent again. And so she sent them again, complying to the request. And that was the one that were formally charged.
Okay.
So she received the funds. So when she received the funds and about which one she is charged with, there's a very very big difference in the time.
Okay.
Line.
So like so basically this the charges are based on the sort of the re-emails in March of this year.
だから今回の事件っていうのはあなたが再送信した分について適圧されたという理解でよろしいんでしょうか。おそらくそうなんですけれども、警察は最初からそのメールで送っていたを送ってるっていう体で逮捕してたっぽいので、全然話が噛み合わなくて最初、全部私が警察に説明
I think so, but the police seem to have thought that, first of all, I sent the data itself and not the URL, and there was a very, I think their, my understanding of the story and their understanding of the story was very different. I'm just going to interject a little bit, because from what we know, what she has been charged with when she has been originally arrested, and what she was charged with when she was detained, because the detention order and the arrest order is handled by different judges, seem to be different. They seem to be different. So the police probably had a misunderstanding when they first arrested her, and after they heard her side of the story, I think they changed the charges. And unfortunately, under our legal system, the lawyers have access to the koryūjō, the writ of detention. We're able to get a copy of that, but we don't have the right to access to the arrest warrant, so we can't be really sure.
Okay, so what do you think she was, the original arrest warrant, you're not sure what she was arrested on, charged with? See, I'm unclear right now, forgive me, I'm just unclear on the Japanese system. Is there a difference between what you're charged with and what you're indicted? You said she hasn't been indicted?
No, okay.
Excuse me, it's just confusing.
I probably have to give you a crash course on Japanese criminal procedure law.
Real short, please.
Real shortly, okay. First of all, when a police arrests somebody, basically you need a warrant, okay? Mm-hmm. And the warrant, you got to specify the charges, okay? And within 48 hours, the police has to send over the case to the prosecutor or that the suspect has to be released. And when the prosecutor receives the case, the prosecutor has 24 hours to either release the suspect or to seek a detention order from the court, okay? And when the prosecutor seeks the detention order of the so the charges written on the original arrest warrant, so that's one paper that needs to be arrested. So another paper is necessary to detain somebody. So arrest and detention require two different warrants. Okay, so the contents of the warrants theoretically could be different. Legally, it has to be the same, because if these two charges are different, the detention order may be dismissed she was dismissed, but she was released, so we don't really have a way of challenging the difference of the discrepancy between the arrest and the detention order.
Okay. And you said she was in custody for 6 days?
あなたが身柄拘束されたら6日間でよろしいかと。はい、そうです。And
she was released based on your appeal?
Yes. だから、yes. だから、まあ彼女が獄中にいたのは6日間で、それで、6日留置場にですね、いたのは、留置場にいたのは6日間で、それで、弁護団の準抗告に釈放されたということです。Yes. Yes. And the quasi-appeal, the 準抗告、yes.
Okay. And Fred, with your indulgence, two quick questions. One is, what do you expect to happen next? And two, for Megumi-san, have you done any crowd funding or crowdsourcing projects prior to this?
First of all, is the first question addressed to me?
Yeah, Mr. Key, what's going to happen? You know, procedurally, what happens next?
Okay, procedurally, first of all, I'm going to go by the textbook. Well, she's been released, right? The investigation still goes on, okay? So the case is still open. The prosecutor can still indict her or dismiss the charges. Prosecutor does not have a time limit to this because she has been released. If she is still in detention, the prosecutor only has 23 days before to make a decision. But now she's free, there's no time limit. Until the statute of limitations comes, this case is open. That's my answer. Okay. And what was the question, Jerry? And for
Megumi-san, is this the first time you've done any crowdsourcing project, and is this going to be the last?
だからあなたね、もう今回の件で、摘発されてクラウドファンディングでやったけども、今回摘発される前にですね、クラウドファンディングでの、えっと、
そのプロジェクトというのをやったことがあるのかと、あるいは今後ともクラウドファンディングで、自分の芸術活動プロジェクトをやっていくつもりがあるのかどうかということについて尋ねています、
はいはい、クラウドファンドを利用したのはそのマンボートプロジェクトが初めてです
。 He says that the Manboat project was the first time that she ever used crowdfunding to finance a project、
mm-hmm. And you plan to do it again or is this going to be the last time?
だからもうそれともうクラウドファンディングやらない、それとも今後ともクラウドファンディングを利用して芸術活動を続けていくつもりがあるんですか。
あ、やっていきたいです。
She wants toContinue on.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead.
I just have one more question. Can you talk about your, can you talk about the conditions that you went through when you were in detention, and what questions did the police ask you when you were in detention?
So you want to know what her life was like in jail?
Yeah.
And as for the second question, we don't really want to discuss that right now. Sorry, is that I don't want to discuss that right now.
で、質問2つあって、1つ目は留置所の生活について何か印象残ったこととか何か言いたいことあるかということ。もう1個は警察の取り調べ何聞かれたのってことだけど、そこはちょっと弁護団的には今の段階で。打ち合わせしない状況で言ったら子供しかないっていうから、その質問は断っちゃった、はい、で最初の質問についてどうぞ。
はい、留置場というのはとても人権を無視したひどいところでですね、まだ犯罪者と確定されたわけではない人もいるのに、検察庁に行くときと裁判所に行くときの護送車に乗っていくんですけれども、そこの待ち合わせる場所っていうのがものすごく狭い部屋 に10人ぐらい押し込めて、ですぐそこはお手洗いなんですけど、そこで、手錠をですねずっとかけたまま、椅子がすごく木の硬い椅子なんですけれども、そこにずっと座っ6時間以上座っていないといけないんですよ。でご飯を食べるときは検察庁は片手にしてもらえるんですが、裁判所で待ってるときは手錠つなぎっぱなしでパンをこうやって食べないといけなかったり、でその部屋っていうのはクーラーがなくて扇風機しかないんですよ。でトレーナーなどを着ていくととても暑いんですが、脱ぐと怒られるんですね。
で、はい、ちょっとそれぐらいでいいかな、はい、First of all, I'm just gonna interrupt you for just for my interpretation purposes. First of all, I found that the jail was a very inhumane place. It's awful. The people there are, still assumed to be innocent. They're presumed to be innocent. For example, when I was in jail, I had to go to the prosecutor's office and the judge and the court. I mean, to go to the prosecutor's office to get for the interrogation by the prosecutor, and also to go to the judge means she has to be interviewed by the judge before she can be detained. And when you go there, what happens is that underground of the prosecutor's office and the judge, you're crammed into these very little rooms, okay, waiting rooms, and you're still handcuffed. It's very tight. There's no air conditioning, and sometimes you're wearing these trainers or long clothes. You're not allowed to take them off. So it's very, and it's very packed, it's very hot, it's very stressful. And for example, you have to sit on these hard wooden benches for like more than 6 hours without talking to anybody. And when you eat, you're given some bread, but in the prosecutor's office, what they do is you're handcuffed, right? They take off one of your handcuffs and place the other handcuff on your other wrist. So your hands are free, although you have the double handcuffs on the other side. But when you're sitting in the waiting room inside the basement of the court building, you have to eat your meals with both of your hands handcuffed.
まだいいですか？その手錠もすごく限界ギリギリまでぎっちりかけられて、指がしびれて痛いとか言っても我慢しろとか言われて、なかなか緩めていただけなかった。
And the handcuffs were placed on very tight.And sometimes, you complain it's too tight. My fingers are becoming numb, and they just said, "我慢しろ, just bear it."
あとですね、お風呂に この夏の季節に週2日しか入れないんですよ。
And in this heat of this summer, you're only allowed to bathe twice a week.
あと私地持ちなんですけれども、トイレ地がちょっと痛いんでボラギノールとかくださいって言ったんですけど、そんなものはないと言われ、じゃあ地の人はどうしたらいいんですかって言ったら、月2回の健康診断の日まで待てと言われたました。
I have to confess that I have hemorrhoids, and you know it's awful. It was painful, so I asked for some medicine for my hemorrhoids, and they refused. And they said then she asked the guards that what should I do? Well, there's a health check every 2 weeks, so you have to wait until then.
あとですね、いろんな病気を持っている方とも部屋が一緒になってしまうんですが、例えば水虫を持っている人とかと同じ部屋になったりとかして、とてもうつってしまうんじゃないかという不安と怖さがあります。
And many of my roommates, they had diseases. Some of them had athlete's foot, and I had to stay in a room with someone with athlete's foot, and I was very afraid that I might catch the athlete's foot.
まだいろいろあるんですけど。
I could go on and on.
漫画にしますそれ。
But she said that she would describe it in a manga, so please buy it.
We're out of time now. Do you have any more time, or if there's any more questions?
I don't know. That's up to you.
No, we're fine.
一応もう3時半になっちゃったんだけど、ロクデナシコさんの方時間の方大丈夫かって言ってる。
もうちょっと、maybe 5 or 10 minutes.
あと5分か10分ぐらい、OK。Yeah, she says 5 or 10 minutes, OK.
OK, lady down the front.
フランス店のドキと申します。3D データが歪説物として立件されたのは日本初ですが、この 3D マンコデータの流通が社会全体の風俗を乱すと思いますか？これ1点目。
So her question was, this is the first time that a 3D data has been, been charged with obscenity, but does Ms. Rokudenashiko think that distribution of her manco's 3D data would have a negative influence on the public morality?
思いません。なぜなら、歪説とかいやらしいものというのは、例えば性行為を彷彿とさせる挿入とか、なんかセックスしているものそのものとか、そういう欲情をさせるものだと思っているんですけれども、その単に性器の一部分を切り取ったもので、果たしてそれが猥褻かどうかというのは私は全く思っておりません。
I don't think it's obscene. It may be obscene or less vicious if you're depicting something that is actually engaging in a sexual intercourse or other sexual activities. But I'm just presenting my part of my body just as it is, and I don't think that is an obscene.
すみません、ありがとうございます。あともう一個、古典やもう漫画もすでに書いていらっしゃるのに。報道では自称アーティストと、ニュースなどにされたことをどう思いますか？
So her question was, how do you think, although you know you've done your own, I mean you're an artist and you have your own book and you've done your own, you have done your own,
I forgot, 古典, how would you say 古典 in English?
Your exhibit, yeah, thank you very much. The exhibit.But nevertheless, a lot of media wrote to you that you were a self-proclaimed artist. How do you think about it?
自称アーティストって言われ
た。はい。実は絶対自称芸術家とかって書かれるんじゃないかなっていうのは思ってたんですよ。
It's something that I had anticipated.
そのぐらい汚い人たち。汚いというか、いらない、ごめん。それぐらいひどいことをもっとされていたので、それぐらいは言うだろうなというのは、はい、あったんですが、思ったんですが、なので、若干諦めてたんですけれども、外に出てきた時に多くの方がそれについて怒ってくださっていたことに、逆に私がびっくりして嬉しかったです。
Well, From my treatment of from I guess surmised much concerning how I was treated with the police, I expect the worst. But so I had anticipated that being labeled as a self-proclaimed artist, But when I was released, I started talking to other people, and I noticed that many of other people were angry at the labels that the police had tried to place on me. And it was very empowering.
Okay, gentleman from Reuters again.
あの、マンボートとかあの、数々の作品とか没収されたんですか?されたままですか?されたままですか?
His question was, your various artworks in the Manboat, are they still confiscated? The answer is yes.
で、どうして欲しいんでしょうか? 少々お待ちください。 ちょっとカメラに戻って、その発言が欲しいんで。あ、あれ、そう、私は質問は彼女宛ての質問、僕宛ての質問。彼女に。似て、そうです。流れ、はい。少々。
そうすると作品については、どういうふうにしてほしいかっていうことです。え、待ってる。で、ちょっと待って、カメラの目線をね、ちょっとずらすから、ちょっと、ずらすから。え、数々の作品はどうなりましたか?すべて、ほとんど押収されてしまいましたので、早く返して、傷をつけないで早く返してほしいです。So
all my artworks has been confiscated by police. I want them back.
要するに人に見せるものがネット以外にはあのネットの以外にはない。あ、もうこれはわいせつじゃないということで、これは持ってかれなかったんですけど。
Except for this little doll that the figure that they thought that it was an obscene, everything was taken away from me.
あとはすべて持っていかれたので、その押収した時の梱包の仕方もすごく粗雑だったので。
And they treated, they did not treat my artwork with my respect when they try to do it, as they try to pack it, and as they try to take it away. So in fact, I helped them pack it so that my artwork would not be destroyed or damaged.
Okay, I think this will have to be the last question. Go ahead.
と一つは弁護士さんに、それは先ほどそのお金のやり取りのことを誤解してた話の続きなんですが、この罪名っていうのは、お金のやり取りがあるかどうかということで、その犯罪が成り立つか成り立たないかっていうのは関係するんでしょうかということです。
The first question was addressed to me. You said something, you told me that the police seemed to have misunderstood about the crowdfunding issue. Now, as for the charges, does it have any relevance? Would it have any difference if there was money involved or some sort of that it had the nature of being a transaction? And the answer is no. The issue that she is charged with distribution, not of sales. Okay, the charges of that of distribution, not of sale. So, whether she was getting paid for it or not is not directly an issue. It may be an aggravating factor, you know, if she was found guilty, that may be treated as an aggravating factor when it comes to determining her sentence. But I mean, whether it would be a crime or not, no, it's not irrelevant. It's not relevant.
それからもう一つそのご本人に伺いたいのですけれども、先ほどのお答えの中で、自分はそのわいせつではないと思っている人に送ってるんだからというのがありましたけれども、それは何かこうやり取りで確認をするということがあったのかどうか、そうではなくて、趣旨に賛同してくれたから、はい、そういう人はそういう助成金をわいせつだというふうに思わない人だっていうふうな、信頼をしたということなんでしょうか。そこのところを伺います。
So, you know, you just previously mentioned that I had only sent these URLs of the data to the persons that, you know, who thought that whatever I'm sending was not obscene.But did you have any, interactions or dialogue with the person with the people that you've sent to confirm that they thought that it was an obscene, or how did you check?
はい、ですね、プロジェクトに応募じゃないや、募金を入れてくれたということは趣旨に賛同してくれた方と理解して、おりまして、またそのプロジェクトが終わった後にも関係ない人たちがマンコ見せてみたいな感じでデータ欲しいみたいなメールも来たんですけれども、そういうものには一切返しておりません。
you know, people who made the crowdfunding, I just assumed that they had agreed with my philosophies and my ideas because it's written on the web page. So I just assumed that they had agreed. And after the crowdfunding, the project was over, there were a lot of people who wrote to me saying, I want to see your vagina, please send me your data. I did not comply.
I have one final technical question. You said you sent an URL for a website. What website was it? Was it her blog or?
URL っていうのは、あの、何の URL だったの？
あの、そのデータを預ける、あの、宅配サービスの、だから道筋みたいな。
So it's just 普通の何、要するにデータストレージサービス。
そうです、オンラインデータサービス。
Now, the URL is just a data, online data storage service.
Okay. Okay, that concludes our question and answer session. I'd like to thank Yamaguchi-san for his excellent work as both as a lawyer and as an interpreter. And most importantly, I'd like to thank our guest today, Rokudenashiko. And as is customary for the club, we'd like to present her with a one-year honorary membership of the club, and we hope she comes back often to enjoy the hospitality here.
だから、ここでね、ゲストになった人に対しては、慣例として1年間有効の名誉会員証を授与するから、ぜひまた遊びに来てください。
ありがとうございます。
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.